Hello, and welcome back to Tips and Time Savers. I'm Danny Rocks, and in today's lesson, I'm going to share my best practice tips for distinguishing the content that you add into a cell or cells in the Excel program from the formatting that you apply to that cell or to other cells. Now, even if you're an Excel veteran, I encourage you to stay tuned for this lesson because I guarantee you're going to learn at least one new tip. It's rare that a week goes by that I don't get a panicked phone call from a client or from a viewer. Danny, I've got this crazy worksheet. I type in a formula and I get all kinds of bizarre results. Can you help me? Well, they send me the worksheet, and the first thing that I want to do is I want to explore the formatting that has been applied to the cells, whether they have content visible or not. So if I type 123 in cell A1, I've added content to that cell. If I then select two cells, A1 and B1, and come up on the Home tab of the ribbon and apply the bold attribute to the font and change the font family, change the font size, add color, align it, or any of the other formatting commands that I see over here on the Home tab of the ribbon. When I come over here into this cell, remember I formatted it before I added content. And I say, well, I really don't want that. I'll go back and I'll press delete. Well, when you press delete, type in another number, you see you've added content, but you deleted the content and left the formatting in place. So first best practice tip is to add the clear command to your quick access toolbar. The clear command has a drop-down menu. In this case, what I want to do is I want to clear all. Clear all will clear both the content and the formatting for my selection. So clear all, and now when I type in 456, you see I now have the font and the font size. I have the default settings. Well, what if I want to leave the content in place and only remove the formatting? Once again, clear command, drop-down menu. In this case, I want to clear the formats. In other words, I'm going to have the content remain in place. So that's an essential command that I want you to add to the Quick Access Toolbar. How do you do that? Home tab of the ribbon over here in the editing group, here's the clear command. Now you can add any command or any command group to the Quick Access Toolbar. Just right mouse click and say add to the Quick Access Toolbar. All right, now let's move over here to another worksheet. What I have over here on the surface is it appears to be a brand new blank worksheet until I start typing. Type the number 1, and my God, and again, this is where the phone starts to ring. Danny, I typed the number 1 in a cell. The font I think I can change, but why did I get January 1st, 1900, and information that it's a Sunday? Type 2 over here, and again, this is all crazy. Well, the reason that the date came up, I'm going to explain in about 30 seconds. What I want to do here is I want to introduce you to a second vital command to add to the Quick Access Toolbar, the Find and Select command, which also has a drop-down menu. In this case, I want to go to Special. And in the Go to Special dialog box, I want to click on Last Cell. When I click on Last Cell, look where the cursor goes down to. It went down to cell F41. And again, I had some data in there. Let's move up here to Control 1. Let's do that again. This time, I'll use a keyboard shortcut, F5, to bring up the go to Special, the Last Cell, and click OK. So you see, this may explain why you sometimes print and you get page after page of blank, because you deleted the content but you left the formatting in place. So as long as there's formatting, that will print out. So we want to be able to scrub this clear. So first off, we have to select all of the cells in the worksheet. One easy way to do that is just click this blank button up here. You see this blank button above row 1 and to the left of column A? Click there, and now we selected all of the cells. If you like keyboard shortcuts, Control A will do the same. Sometimes you have to hit Control A twice if you selected a cell inside of a range. So now that we've selected it, come over here and we want to clear all. So now when I type in 123, I have the content without any special formatting applied to it. Now remember a few minutes ago when I typed in 1 and I got a result of January 1st, 1900. That brings up the next part of our lesson, distinguishing between how data is stored in Excel and how we choose to display it in our workbook. So the number one in Excel is actually the day that Excel began tracking time. So if I come over here and if I change one to be a long date, that's where the Sunday, January 1st, 1900 came up. As far as Excel is concerned, that is when time began. If I come down here and if I want to use this keyboard shortcut, Control plus semicolon to get the current date, Control plus semicolon, I'm going to see that the current date is going to display in the short date format. What I want to do is I want to use this keyboard shortcut, Control plus tilde over here, Control tilde, and what's actually being stored in Excel is 40,844. In other words, day one, January 1st, 1900, the current date that we have, and I'll toggle off December 7th, 2011, there were 40,884 days in between. So you see, we can come over here and we can change this to any date format that we wish. Let's pick this one. Just come over here and change it into a short date, and there you go. And I could autofill down here to autofill the formatting, and let's choose that. I want to fill the formatting only. So you see, you can make any changes to the format, but understanding how Excel stores the data is going to be a key to your mastery of Excel. Time over here, time is stored as a decimal portion of 1. So 0.5, when I change the formatting over here to be a different time, for example, I come down here and I want to add in the AM PM. So 0.5 is 12 noon. Well, think about it. There are 24 hours in the day. So when 50% of the day has elapsed, 0.5 is 50%, then the time is 12 noon. Let's come down here and use another keyboard shortcut, Control Shift and colon, to get the current time. Control Shift colon. So the current time over here, but remember, if I use this keyboard shortcut, Control plus tilde, I'll see how Excel is storing that. So it's going to store this decimal portion of 1, and I can choose any way to use the formatting to display it to make it easier to understand. Now, something that's very special with time is when you're doing a calculation with time, in other words, with hours worked. So 8 hours worked for 5 days, we're expecting the result to be 40. Well, watch what happens when I go to sum. I'll do equal sum, and what I want to do is make a selection over here. Watch what will happen. I'm going to get a crazy result, 16. Well, what do you mean? You saw that I selected all of the cells for the sum. Why did 16 show up and not 40? Well, for hours that exceed 24 hours in a calculation, apply this special formatting. Left bracket, the letter H, which stands for hour, right bracket, colon, and then MM. So let's do that. Let's right mouse click and say format the cells, and what we want to do is we want to come in to custom. Now you're not going to see a left bracket, H right bracket, so pick one that's close and then come up here and edit it. So we'll add a left bracket, H right bracket, and then click OK, and now the result is what we're expecting, 40 hours. So two keyboard shortcuts for the current date, Control semicolon, current time, Control shift colon, toggle Control tilde to reveal what's actually being stored in Excel, and toggle it back and then see how that information is being displayed. With formulas, what you are storing is you're storing the actual formula. What's being shown in the cell is the result of the formula. So there are some of my best practice tips that I have for Excel, and I'll use Control Tab to go back to another Excel workbook that I have, and I'll just quickly draw your attention to my new online shopping cart, shop.thecompanyrocks.com, where you can take advantage of my best-selling DVD-ROM, The 50 Best Tips for Excel 2007. And I will look for you in the next lesson.